Ladies and gentlemen, hello, welcome along to our latest in-depth walk around piece. This time focusing on Viking's latest fixed chamber round baillet. Now you may have seen it already in our review video of the Valtra G Series, but for this video we are going to focus on the baillet, learn a lot more about it, and to help us do that we have the man himself from Viking UK, Mr. Mike Howell.
Hi, how are we? I'm good, thanks.
Marvellous. Sun's out in Lancashire, which is a first for everything. Makes a change. And considering it's September, it's not too bad.
It'll do.
So, Fixed Bell 500, give us a bit of background to start with. Sort of where does it fit in the Viking family? What does it replace?
Right, this is the new Fixed Bell 500 heavy duty fixed chamber baler. It's a replacement for our old 4325 baler, and we've gone, you know, heavy duty, bigger rollers, bigger rotor, wider pickup reel, so we've really beefed the machine.
So it's a beefy little swine.
It is.
For the UK and Irish grass market.
Yeah, heavy wet grass, this is the machine you need.
Ideal. Now looking at it sort of, you know, outside perspective as I have and many other people have, it looks like you've taken a lot of sort of design cues and inspiration from the fast bale, your non-stop round baler.
We have, yeah.
You know, it's got to say, well and truly put you guys back on the map, and this looks like a continuation of that.
Yeah, we've stolen little bits and added them to this, you know, just to keep the line through the family, you know, fast bale, fixed bale, you know, the name kind of flows through as well. And as I say, I mean, we've taken, you know, sprockets and roller sizes and roller bearings off the fast bale and added them to the new fixed bale here.
Perfect. Right then, Mike, where should we start? Let's start at the front, shall we?
Yep,
so drive lines.
Yeah, drive line. 540 drive in. Now we now have a one-piece gearbox across the front,
right?
Just like the fast bale. It's the jack and the drawbar is actually fixed to the gearbox housing. So the drive goes out right-hand side for your rotor, out to the left to actually drive your rollers.
So that's a structural component then.
Structural component, strong, heavy-duty, well-built gearbox in there.
Perfect. And then from there, where do we go to?
Pickup reel. We have a new pickup reel. We've gone from 2.2 metres wide to 2.3 metres wide, so we've got an extra tine either side.
Right.
Our tines are now 10 millimetres longer, and the actual stripper loops are 4 millimetres closer.
Okay, so a little bit less debris in amongst the pickup reel.
That's
there.
It, yeah. So it's 2.3 flare to flare. We've got a new crop press roller with inboard bearings. These are thicker and heavier, yeah, and we have a new fixing arrangement there. The gauge wheels on the side, the widest part of the machine is still the outside of the road wheel.
And this is on 500 tyres, right?
This is on 500, you know, but we do have options of tyres as well.
Okay, but on this particular model, that would be your widest point. So these are pretty much almost in line with that.
Almost in line, but we can now actually take these off, and we have a convenient storage point there if you needed to actually take them off.
Got you.
We have a new rotor as well. We're 20% bigger than the 4325. We're now 520mm, and we're now a 15-blade chopping system as opposed to a 14.
Okay.
We've still got our famous parallel action drop floor, but we've actually altered the profile of the drop floor to give it a more smoother intake, and combined with a new rotor, you know, the intake is really impressive, which we'll hopefully see later today.
Like an almost sort of flatter route into the chamber itself.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay,
yeah,
that's right. And then just going back to that knife bank then, how many knives? Did you say
15?
15,
yeah.
Can your chopping chain switch out, or is that...
No, it's 15 in, 15 out. I mean, you can get blanking plates where you could, you know, maybe take every other one out if you wanted, but it's all in, all out.
Okay, and in terms of sort of future developments, do you think that's something you might be looking at in terms of adding more knives and being able to, like, put half of them in, half of them out as the day goes on?
Never say never.
Never say never.
Never say never, yeah. Right, we still retain our power by net system. Yeah, which is a injector plate. The net is held in the plate and fed directly into the chamber, so there's no influence with wind or anything. We've still got the lowest loading height on the market, operated from the cab.
Yeah.
Lift your brake up, old carton off, new carton off, and then there's a handy diagram up there to tell you how to thread it.
Just in case you forget.
And then it's like straight into the injector plate, back to the cab, press the same button that you press to lift the brake up, that then brings the brake back down, and then you're ready to go. 5 minutes, you're off baling again. So we've got spare roll this side, spare roll the opposite side, so we've got enough for a real big day's baling.
And then, so just going back to pickup reel, sort of like the lift mechanism looks a little bit different.
Yes, that's it.
Predecessor.
On the 4325, we had bars here, yeah, with the springs on. We've now gone to the spring and cylinder combined underneath. So if you want to alter the suspension, there's a circlip there that you just move up and down. But that's the kind of thing. Once you tend to set it, it's
almost set and forget.
Pretty much set and forget.
Got you. Now, speaking of beefiness, talk me through these chains and sprockets and bearings.
Right,
they're something else then.
Right, we've gone to heavy duty chains, HPC chains, yeah, which inch and a quarter there, and we've gone from 5/8 to 3/4 drive on the pickup reel. We've got 18 rollers. All the sprockets are held on with a taper lock now, and we've got 50 millimeter bearings left and right, and then in the critical areas, which are identified by the multi-fixing taper locks.
Yeah, so the high-load areas.
Yeah, we have a double-race 50 mil bearing.
Okay, yeah. And then you just mentioned the number of rollers in the chamber then. Has that altered at all?
Yes, we were on 17, we're now on 18, so, you know, we've got more pressure in there. You know, we can make a real, real good bale with this machine.
I hope so.
we've now gone to a hydraulic tailgate. In the past, we've had locks, but then prior to that we did have a hydraulic door as well, so we've gone back to a hydraulic door. One, it protects the machine, and two, you can actually alter the density from the cab on the move if you really want to.
Okay.
so you can get a real nice tidy bale.
Perfect. And then bit of lubrication of all these components, what you got?
Well, we've got a new Dropsa oiler system with a 7-litre tank, new high capacity pump, which you can alter the outlets on each
outlet. You can alter that.
Yeah. So if you just adjust the screw up and down, you can control the amount of oil per chain. Some people say a full day, some people say a full day. It really is personal preference.
Right.
You know, but you can adjust it on there. Yeah. Lubrication wise, we have grease banks that you can just see up there.
Oh yeah, there's one.
Yeah. Yeah, so there's one for this side of the tailgate, one for the other side of the tailgate, then there'll be one for the front this side, and one for the front half of the bale chamber on the opposite side. Put your grease gun on, one pump, and then there's a shuttle that'll move across, and then
does
pump
the
again.
Bit.
Yeah, exactly. So you know that each one is getting a nice metered amount of grease. You're not over greasing, but I'm a real great believer in oil and grease, because it's a cheap mechanic. Look after the machine, it looks after you. Another point we now have maintenance wise, we have indicators on the chains. So you know, in the morning, when you're just checking the machine round, as long as that's in line with the washer there, you're fine. If not, you're good to go. If not, just adjust it down till that's in line there.